Hi, my name is Justin Quinn, DMS Product Manager for DX1, and I'm back for our May release highlight and Go Faster Tip of the Month video. We've added some cool new features and updated a few existing ones, so let's go ahead and jump right in and take a look. Coming soon, DX1 now allows you to receive units into inventory before they actually arrive. Simply click the Not Yet Received toggle when receiving the unit, and now you can advertise your units on your website right away as coming soon, create detailed quotes and/or deals that include requested parts and service. No need to switch out the units and rebuild requested parts or service invoices when the unit arrives. This should save you a lot of time. We also added in one-click access to receive the unit when it does arrive, and this should really help dealers get those leads into the dealership while still waiting on units to ship. Inventory sort override. List your inventory in the order you want on your DX1 website. We've added in a setting to DX1 called inventory sorting that allows you to manually override inventory sort order for listings in your website. And those sort type options include default, which is no override, category override, maybe you want to show snowmobiles first, a manufacturer override, perhaps you want to show Polaris models first, a manufacturer and category override, I want to show Polaris snowmobiles first, and inventory priority override. You just want to show all your inventory in the order you want. DX1 Planner Updates. We've made several changes to enhance the planner in DX1, and some of those changes include a new planner look with a customizable planner view. You can configure the planner view based off of the dealership hours and days of operation. We have a user view. Users will now only see the scheduled actions that have been created by them, and managers will see all scheduled actions for all reps when looking at the calendar. We also added an email scheduled action function, so emails set as scheduled action will be sent automatically on the scheduled date and time, and you can now add scheduled actions from within the planner itself. A parts inventory report update. In the last bin improvements for this year, we added bins 1, 2, and 3 to the parts inventory current valuation by part number report, as well as the printable version. This should really help when you're looking at your inventory to see all locations for bins 1, 2, and 3 for any part. Preferred notification on service scheduler. We have added a preferred notification method dropdown to the schedule appointment pop-up window. This allows you to set a preferred notification method for a customer if it had not been previously set. And this allows you to do things like to send appointment confirmations and reminders for those events set in service scheduler. Microfiche. We've updated the thumbnails to be larger, and we've added the OEM name in the page tab. We've updated our parts fiche with larger thumbnails for better visibility of the parts. The thumbnail will now appear larger and clear. In addition, the manufacturer will appear in the page tab. We have done this so that if you have multiple fish tab opens, you can easily identify which one you want to maneuver to. And now, our May Go Faster Tip of the Month. Did you know that in DX1, if you want to add notes to be visible when looking at a customer and an invoice, you can do that? Open up the customer detail part of the window, go to the customer status, add in whatever notes you want, save it, and then when you return to the invoice, you'll see a red icon next to the customer name in the invoice. Simply hover over that and see the notes you added. So that's it for us for DX1 for our May release highlights and Go Faster Tips of the Month. Hope you enjoy them, and I'll see you next month.